Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. This is Delmer again, and today I'm really excited because I'm going to continue the videos with the AR Foundation. I also wanted to apologize because I haven't been producing as many videos as I normally produce. I've been super busy in the morning with my day job, but I'm going to be resuming the frequency of videos that I've been producing for the last couple of years. So today I have something really cool to show you, which is going to be playing behind the scenes. In that demo, I created it because I know a lot of you asked me for how to actually draw and make sure that anything that you're drawing is staying in place. So the way that I did that is I'm using what's called the AR Anchor Manager. I'm going to show you how we can use the line render and how can we pair that with the anchors that we're creating for AR, and also how we can make it look realistic, which is what I'm going to show you in this video. So let's jump into Unity and start working on it. All right, guys, so let me show you what we're going to be looking at today. And I decided to create a drawing app that it's going to be using anchors, also reticles. You guys can see how we started the experience. And what I wanted to show you here is how you can actually draw. So what I'm doing right now is I'm walking and I'm pressing on my finger and I'm moving my phone around. You can see how the lines are all basically staying in place. The reason why they're staying in place is because I'm using a component called the AR Anchor Manager. And I'm creating an anchor every time I create a line render. You guys can see how that one looks. I also have a login here that allows me to see what's going on just in case I need it to debug. And this one, you can see I'm creating a line. And all I'm doing is just moving my phone forward and then back. And here I'm gonna try to do a little cartoon. The first one didn't work, so let's try this one now and see if it works. Let's do the eyes, the nose, the smile. And I forgot the arms. And you can see how the depth is important. So if I walk forward, it's going to matter, right? Because we are in AR. So in this case, I am staying in place. I'm not moving around. So you guys can see how the stick figure now looks a lot better. And in here, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna start drawing. I'm gonna walk back and you can see how it's kind of creating a tunnel. And that's one of the cool things about AR and using the anchors, because this is actually extending the reality. I'm walking around and the lines are all based on, you know, what's happening in the real world. And you guys can see how this one, just drawing a couple of lines. And I'll show you, if I walk back, I'm gonna show you how the perspective looks when I actually rotate around, which is what you see right now. And it's getting my phone close to those lines and just looking at all the crazy stuff that I drew here. I'm not an artist, so I try to do my best. So I also have a little restart experience here. And the reason why I'm putting this close to the table is so that you don't see the planes that get generated. As soon as the planes get generated, I'm going to allow you to draw. Otherwise, I won't allow you to draw. The reason for that is because I want the lines to stay in place, and we need to basically create what's called trackables in order for these lines to look and stay in place. So what I'm gonna do today is basically just walk you through this. This is going to be all available on GitHub. So you're gonna be able to download it, try it, use it. I'm going to put it in Patreon first, and then it's going to make it into GitHub for everybody in about 7 days is when I'll make it available for everyone. So what I'm gonna do is let's go ahead and look at some of the hierarchy first before we get into the code. So this is, you know, basically the setup that I do on every AR Foundation experience. We have our light, AR session, AR session origin. I'm not gonna walk you through some of those components because those are basically boilerplate, so just watch my videos about AR Foundation in my playlist, and you guys are gonna be able to learn that. So most of the stuff are happening in the AR session origin. I have, of course, that component. I also have the AR Anchor Manager. This is the one that it's actually making the lines stay in place. So if I go back to the video, and it's gonna show you what I mean by creating an anchor. And we go forward, maybe right about here. So if I don't create an anchor and I start drawing these lines and I start walking around, what's gonna happen is those lines are gonna stay with my phone. They're basically not gonna be relative to AR, right? Like they're not gonna know where to stay in relation to all the other components that I'm creating in AR. So by creating an anchor, you're creating a position, a trackable, something that AR Foundation is gonna track the position and it's going to make it look real, right? It's going to look right. So that's what this AR anchor is. It used to be called the AR Reference Manager and Reference Point Manager. And I'm glad that Unity change it, because that's what Android calls it as well, which I think is more correct. It's actually an anchor. So go ahead and close out of this. The other thing is a plane manager, right? Like when we started the experience, and let me go ahead and go back to that. I shouldn't have closed it. So when I started the experience, you remember that as soon as the app opens up, right here, you're gonna get a little, you know, kind of like a loading screen. This is basically a phone that is telling you to move your phone around until it finds a plane. I'm not showing the planes, but what's happening here is the airplane manager actually created a plane based on the surface of my office. And the reason why I do that is because I want to know when I need to stop doing the recycle animation so that I can allow you to draw. So I use the plane manager as a reference point to know where, at what point I can start drawing. And if you don't do that, it's not gonna look right. If you start drawing anchors around, I wanted to create planes, and I also am gonna try with feature points, but I'll show you that in a different video. For now, just know that this is the one responsible for basically tracking my room and basically creating planes, vertical planes, horizontal planes. Once I detect one, I'm going to start the experience. And as soon as the experience starts, I'm going to allow you to draw. So I'm gonna show you the life cycle of the experience and how I coded it, but just know that this is, you know, Airplane Manager. And then I have another component called the AirDraw Manager. This is basically what is allowing me to do all these, I wouldn't say artistic lines because they're not, but basically to draw all those lines, right? This is what is actually creating the line renders and then capturing all the different points in relation to where I am with, you know, in the location where I'm drawing with my phone. So let's go ahead and let's keep these open so that I can reference to it. So this is gonna be at what point do I draw the first point. It's just a distance from the camera. I set it to 0.3. You can change that if you like. I think this is more realistic, so I set it to that. Everything is in meters, so this is gonna be, you know, 0.3 of a meter. And then also the color material. Right now I'm just doing, you know, a white line. I'm going to be extending this video, so you'll see a lot of cool stuff that we're gonna be doing with this video, which means that I'm gonna have different materials, randomized materials for now. Just one material, it's just white, pretty simple. And then the corner vertices, these are gonna be basically the corners of every point. So let's see if we can get to right about here. You're gonna see how there's a little roundness around it. That means that I'm basically going to, what I'm doing here, and just basically making it round so that it looks like that. If you set it to zero, it's gonna look flat. It just depends on how you want your lines to look like. So I have corner vertices, end cap vertices. These are used for the line render. These are components that the line render has. The other options in here, I also have what's called allow simplification. Again, this is gonna be a component of the line render, and you can use it if you want. The lines don't look right if you enable it, but I have it in here just for testing. So I have the allow simplification. If I allow it, that means after 20 points, I'm going to be calling the algorithm that they have, that Unity has, for simplifying a line. That might be helpful depending on the experience that you're building. Maybe you do want straight lines and you want these lines to be simplified. So you can play with these three settings in order for you to do that. This one is also really helpful because it'll allow me to determine at what point do I draw. Basically, I create a new point. So right now I'm just saying, you know, when you get to this distance from one point to another, I'm going to draw a new point. So the higher the number, the basically it's going to look like a flat line if you increment this number. The other thing that I added also is maybe when we're drawing, we want to capture some information. We may want to do an animation or maybe change the state of the UI. So I have this Unity event that allows you to, it's gonna get called every time you're drawing. So you can basically, you know, add anything you want in here. If you have some kind of a 3D model, maybe you want to animate. So you can use that Unity event for that. The other piece that I also have is the anchor manager. So if you go up here, here's the anchor manager. The reason why I have a reference here is because I need the anchor manager in order for me to create an anchor. So if I'm drawing points, I need to know where I'm going to be creating a new anchor. So as soon as I create a new line, the anchor manager, I grab the anchor manager and I say, okay, you know what? I want to create a new anchor. So the anchor manager has that option to add an anchor so that I'm basically just passing in the position. And the AR camera, so I have a reference to that. I don't remember why I'm using that here, but I have a reference to that. also the default color of the line, and also the line width. The other piece to this is going to be what I call the AR Experience Manager. Right now I'm using it just to determine at what point I want to draw, right? Like if the airplane manager already found a plane and it was successful, then the AR Experience Manager is going to say, okay, you know what? We already found a plane, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to allow you to draw. So I'm going to call the AR Draw Manager. AR Draw Manager is going to say, oh yeah, I'm going to allow you to draw, so you're going to be drawing. I also have something called restart the experience, which means that the AR Draw Manager can tell the, basically any component can tell the AR Experience Manager to restart itself, meaning that we're going to start from the beginning, we're going to be shutting down the airplane manager, and then we're going to basically go through that cycle one more time. So in here, what I'm doing is on initialize, I am saying, okay, you know what, I'm not going to allow you to draw. So if you look in here, this says allow to draw, and okay, I think I got that wrong. So what's gonna happen is when initialize is called, that means that the airplane manager found a plane. So I'm going to allow you to draw. I'm going to be basically turning off the recycle. And if you look in here and we start this animation, and so you can see that's plane, right? So if we go back into here and you look at the Air Experience Manager, it's going to say, you know what, I'm going to hide that component because we already found a plane, so there's no need to basically to show you that. And then the last thing that I'm gonna do is I'm gonna show you a restart button, which is gonna be basically this one right here, which is gonna be showing on the very bottom. Because at that point, we already started the experience, so I'm gonna allow you to restart the experience. If we go to the restart button and we go down here, you're gonna see that if you press that, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna clear lines. So AR Draw Manager also has that method, and I also have the restart method that I was telling you about on the AR Experience Manager that is going to allow me to restart everything. We basically just start from the very beginning. So we go back to AR session and let's go back down here. So on restart, as soon as I restart and I call this method, what's gonna happen is I'm not gonna allow you to draw, so you can't really draw because we haven't really found any plane. I'm going to restart the recycle, which means that we're going to be animating this guy. And then I'm not gonna show the restart button because we haven't started the experience. Then the last piece here is just a debug manager. That's basically what shows you the debug information that you saw on the experience. So that's basically everything in here. Let's go ahead and jump into the code because I know that many of you were interested in this code from an application that I was developing a few months ago. So let's go ahead and close out of here. And so I'm gonna show you these components in the order of the experience. So again, this is gonna be the one that is controlling when we can start drawing, when do we stop drawing. So I have a couple of things in here. I have a private method, which is a Unity event. And this is on initialize, it's gonna get executed as soon as we found a plane. Anything that this has is going to be invoked. Then I also have another Unity event for unrestarted. So anything that is attached to this Unity event, it's going to get invoked, which is basically the components that I show you in here. So this is gonna get invoked or this is gonna get invoked depending on who calls these two Unity events. And the last thing in here is gonna be the airplane manager, right? We need to tell the AR Experience Manager when the actual AR plane finds a plane. So I'm gonna show you how that works. So that's just a reference. And then also a private Boolean variable determining when we initialize the AR Experience Manager. So if we go down here on the awake and just getting that component, I'm also binding to the planes change. And the reason why I need to do that is because the AR Plane Manager is going to tell us at what point we find a plane. And then this is just for me to be able to run it in Unity. So in Unity, we're not gonna have a plane manager. So I'm just gonna say, you know what? I'm just going to initialize everything and I'm going to set the airplane manager, just basically mocking up that state. The other thing that happens if I'm running this on my phone, this is gonna get called and I'm gonna say, okay, if we haven't initialized, I'm gonna activate this component. And the activate is just gonna, you know, put this on the logger. And then I'm gonna say, you know, call everything that is on the initialize. I'm gonna set the property initialize to true. And I'm gonna basically set the airplane manager to false because we already initialized the experience. There's no need for us to be capturing planes. And the reverse of this is gonna happen on the restart. It's gonna print some information. I'm going to be invoking the unrestarted. I'm basically gonna change this to false instead of true. And I'm gonna set the airplane manager back to true because we need to capture the new plane. So that's how this AR experience manager works. So let's go ahead and go into the AirDraw manager. So on the AirDraw manager, I decided to make sure that we have a required component. Required component is gonna be the AR anchor manager, because if we don't have this component, your lines are not gonna look right. They're not gonna stay in the right position. That's basically what's gonna happen if you start drawing without adding anchors. So I'm using a singleton, so you guys can look at my implementation of singleton. This is basically what Unity provides in their documentation. And if we go back here, so this is the class name. I show you some of these properties already through the inspector. So distance from the camera, default color, the corner vertices, end cap vertices, some of the tolerance options so that we can simplify the lines. And this is just basically a couple of variables. This is a Unity vein that I have in here just in case you want to call something else while you're drawing. I also have a reference to the AR anchor manager. I'm losing my voice by this time. But anyways, I'm gonna be basically putting this code in GitHub so you guys can check it out. But most of these are just, you know, variables that I'm going to be using below, default color. These are some things that I'm gonna be using in the future for randomization of colors. As of the line width, I show you that as well. And then these are some of the private variables that I'm using here. So I am using line render, and this is a component of Unity that allows you to draw lines. So I have a previous line render, I have a current line render, and I'm gonna show you why I use that. I also keep track of all the different anchors in a list, and I also keep track of all the different line renders that I have created, and also the position count, because we're gonna be using this position count to determine how many points or what points we're putting on the lines, and also the previous point distance. This one is gonna allow us to tell the AR Experience Manager is going to be telling the AirDraw manager when we can draw. So that's why I have this private property. Couple of things in here. This component works basically in the Unity editor. If I'm using it in the Unity editor, we're going to be capturing basically input type on the keyboard. And then in this case, I'm using just the mouse. And then if I'm using my phone, it's going to be touches, right? So that's basically what this is doing. And this is the method that I'm exposing that allows me to tell the AirDraw manager from the AR Experience Manager when I can draw and when I cannot draw anymore. I just have a set line settings, which is basically just setting a couple settings on the lines, the width, the vertices, and also whether we're going to be simplifying the start color and the end color. And the draw and touch is the one that is doing most of the work here. So this is so that we can stop drawing. So if I don't have this set, then basically if I have it set to true, that means that we can draw. So it's gonna be false, right? It's not gonna return. So if it's set to false, it's gonna return. That means that we can't really draw. So just getting the touch position, and just, you know, a lot of boilerplate here. This is a method that I call on, you know, every time I touch the screen. So this is gonna be the first thing that gets executed when I first touch the screen, because this is the beginning phase of the touch. So know that this is only going to be executed the first time. As soon as you release your finger, it won't get executed. So it'll just be on every line, every new line that we create. And this is what's doing the magic. So I know a lot of you ask me, how do we keep track and actually make sure that the position is right and also the rotation? So I use the AR anchor, right? So you say anchor manager at anchor, you pass a pose. The pose is going to be the touch position. And in this case, I'm just doing the quaternion, the identity. And I'm saying, you know what, if the anchor for whatever reason wasn't created, I'm just going to just log that to the debug log. I should have used this, but I think in this case it's fine. Otherwise, I'm just going to be adding that anchor to my list of anchors. So this is that list that I show you above it. And then I'm also just, you know, displaying to the UI that I created an anchor, and this is how many anchors we have so far. Then if I'm not touching, if we touch the first time and we haven't let go, this is gonna get executed. But if I move my finger and I haven't released my finger, this method will get executed. So just know that. We'll get back to the update line. So on the annual line render, This was going to create a new line render. We're going to initialize our position to 2. We're going to be creating a new game object. I'm going to name it line render underscore the count. I'm just going to say, okay, you know what? If I have an anchor, I'm going to be using the anchor transform to basically to be the parent of this object. So the reason why the lines are staying in place is because the anchor is created, but the child is going to be this game object. So this is really important, because if you don't do the anchor, it's just going to be the transform. And this works for desktop type applications and other type of applications, but for AR, you need to make sure that you use the anchor. And then I'm just setting the go transform position, which is going to be that position of this, to be the touch position. Just, you know, created a tag called line. I add the new component of line render. I set up all the properties here, additional properties. And then I set my variables, my current line render, my previous line render. I add this to the line, and I just basically just show these on the AR debug manager. So if we go back up to the update line method. So the other thing, well, let's go ahead and look at this, and then I'll show you the draw mouse. So if we go to the update line method, it's going to be, so we're going to be passing in the touch position. The reason why I'm capturing the previous point distance is so that I know the distance between the previous point and the new point. So if the previous point distance is null, we're going to be just setting the touch position. Then I'm going to say, okay, if the previous point distance is not null, then I'm going to calculate the new touch position with the previous point distance. And then I'm going to say, if we're beyond the threshold, I'm going to be creating a new point. So this is what allows me to determine at what point I create a new point. So I just set the previous point distance to the touch position, and then I just add a new point. And that new point just basically adds a new line to a new point to the line. And the implementation on the draw on mouse is very similar to the other implementation. All I'm doing here is I'm basically getting the mouse position, and I'm just getting, you know, the clicks from the actual mouse. So the code is very similar. I'm also not creating an anchor here, because there's really no reason to create an anchor if I'm just drawing and creating an application for a desktop type application. So that is everything that I wanted to cover today. I know this was a lot, but I'm going to be putting this in GitHub. In fact, if we go right now to GitHub, I'm going to show you the repo pretty fast. It's going to GitHub, the DelmerV. We go to the repos. I'm going to be putting, again, this is going to be in Patreon, available tonight, and I'm going to make it available in a week to everyone in GitHub. But the repo is going to be called ARDraw, and everything is going to be here. I haven't checked in some of my changes, but I'm going to be checking them in tonight. So that's everything that I wanted to show you guys. If you guys have any questions, please let me know.